Hi, I'm Dr. Zyrowski from NewVisionExcel.com, and in this video, we're going to be talking about the top endocrine disrupting chemicals that are in your food. Whether you're going to the grocery store and getting fresh fruits and vegetables, or you're getting packaged foods, there's so many different chemicals that are found in our foods today that are disrupting normal bodily function as you know it. Now, an endocrine disruptor is anything that, or I should say, any pollutant that interrupts normal biological pathways within an organism. That organism being your body, and those pathways being anything from proper hormonal function to proper digestion. Food today is loaded with pollutants, and it's so important to be able to identify the different pollutants that are in the different foods and which foods you should always stay away from. So let's go ahead and dive into which foods you need to stay away from and which chemicals to look for in order to make sure that you are avoiding the endocrine disruptors that are just so prevalent in today's food supply. Number one on our list is going to be soy. Whenever possible, stay away from soy. And the reason for that is because 90%+ of soy is GMO. The other reason that you really want to stay away from soy is because it's what's known as a phytoestrogen. It mimics estrogen in our body and it can lead to estrogen dominance. Now, many different poor quality products on the market have soy, but even some that are perceived to be high quality products contain soy as well. So we need to make sure that we're staying away from nutritional supplements and different food products that are high in soy. And if you have little ones at home, you need to make sure that you're checking the baby formulas, because a major ingredient in most baby formulas is in fact soy. The only time soy is acceptable is when it's organic and fermented. So unless you're consuming organic fermented soy, don't consume soy at all. The next thing that we need to talk about is vegetable oil. The reason that you need to stay away from vegetable oil is because it's made from all GMO crops. So things such as corn, soy, and canola. And when these different crops are GMO, not only do they have some issues we'll talk about in a second here, but you know, vegetable oil is considered to be a bad oil. And when you're consuming these different bad fats, what they're doing is they're actually attaching to our cell membrane, they're getting into our nervous system, and they're becoming part of self. And that's when you start to have a bunch of dysfunction. So you need to make sure that you're sticking to high quality fats such as coconut oil or olive oil. So the third topic on our list of endocrine disrupting chemicals and foods to avoid is going to be GMOs. And the reason that you want to stay away from GMOs is because it's a crop that has an altered state from the way that it was originally designed to be. So what they're doing is they're taking things such as pesticides and viruses, and they're actually lacing it right into the DNA of the different crops out there. Corn is a major one that has this issue. Wheat is another major one that has this issue. You know, this is why so many people are having sensitivities to gluten today and having problems eating wheat and having reactions to corn. So we need to make sure that we're staying away from these different GMO crops. So whenever you go to buy either fruits or vegetables, make sure you're staying away from the GMOs, okay? The other thing that we need to talk about when we're having this discussion of eating fruits and vegetables is to make sure that you're staying away from foods that are sprayed with the different pesticides. There's one out there called organophosphate pesticide. You know, these different pesticides are actually designed to destroy the nervous system of bugs, and that's, you know, ultimately why we get these beautiful crops at the store. I mean, yes, they look beautiful, but if they're toxic, then they aren't going to do us a whole lot of good. And if they are going in and destroying and killing the bug by destroying their nervous system, then it's going to have an effect on us. As a matter of fact, when some of these different pesticides were brought into other countries around the world, just small tribes that were actually not just, they were just using regular natural farming methods, and they brought some of these pesticides in. And what happened is their neurological disorders, not only in their young but also their elderly, just increased and skyrocketed. So we want to make sure that when we're buying fruits and vegetables, we're making sure that we're either buying them from a source that we can trust or buying them organic, because we do not want pesticides and chemicals on the food that we're eating. The next big food that you need to stay away from is conventional dairy, because the conventional dairy that you're buying from the grocery store is loaded with all kinds of different toxins. There was a matter of fact, there was a study done where they found over 22 different chemicals in conventional dairy milk. So you need to make sure that you're sticking to the grass-fed dairy with pasture-raised cows in order to avoid things such as growth hormone, antibiotics, steroids, and all the things that were given to these different cows over the years in order to make them produce a huge amount of milk. Because when they're given to the animal that's actually producing the product that you're consuming, you are going to consume those different chemicals as well. The last food that we're going to talk about today is going to be artificial sweeteners. You need to really make sure you're watching those artificial sweeteners. They're in many foods today, and they're also in a lot of sodas. And most people think that they're doing themselves a huge favor by consuming the artificial sweeteners because it says zero calories. And as a matter of fact, it's causing so many neurological disorders, disrupting brain function, but it also is disrupting hormones as well in a process called pregnenolone steal, where it goes and it alters the conversion of cholesterol to hormones. So make sure you're staying away from artificial sweeteners, and as a matter of fact, make sure you're staying away from sugar as well, because what we're finding, and there's so much science coming out, that sugar is absolutely just destroying the human body and causing a complete degeneration, not only of our nervous system, but our musculoskeletal system. So you need to really avoid the sugar as much as possible. Now, the last thing we're going to talk about is going to be water. Now, I understand water is not a food. However, it's something that people are consuming every day that is loaded with toxins. It always surprises me how many people go to the faucet or go to the tap with no concern of whether or not the water has chemicals in it, or how often do you go to a restaurant and they just serve you plain old tap water, even nice restaurants, right? And so when we look at the water, in many cases, it has arsenic in it, it has lead in it, it has fluoride in it and chlorine in it. So we need to make sure that we're drinking good, pure water. All these different chemicals that I had just mentioned are neurotoxins, and they will affect our body. You know, as a matter of fact, in the different fishing communities, what they found is that some of these different fish, not only do they have many of these items, these chemicals I had already mentioned, but they're finding that they have pharmaceuticals in them. They're finding fish with Ritalin in them. They're finding fish with estrogen dominance in them due to so many women taking birth control. So make sure that you're getting good, clean water, and make sure that you are getting the water tested in your home so that you're not getting all these impurities. I hope you enjoyed this information, in that it really gave you a lot of knowledge in order to make sure that you are staying healthy and not eating things and consuming products that are disrupting your endocrine system. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up and also subscribe to my channel. And if you have any questions, as always, make sure you drop them below in the comment section. Thank you, and make it a great day.